Hello, and welcome to this video user guide for the CoCoRaHS app. The primary goal of the CoCoRaHS mobile app was to replicate the features of the older apps, which will no longer be supported. Like the older apps, the new app allows observers to easily view, edit, and submit their daily and multi-day precipitation reports. Now, in addition to those core functions, the app also supports reporting for hail, significant weather and condition monitoring observations, a monthly zeros form, and a variety of brand new features, most of which we will go over in this video. Let's get started. There are basically three ways to use or install the app, and all three have the same overall features and are no different other than a couple of details that we will go over in this guide. The first way is to simply use the website. Whether on a smartphone, tablet, or laptop, or even a desktop computer, you can simply go to mobile.cocoraHS.org to use the new app. We'll go over some of the reasons why you'd want to do this in a moment. The next way is to save the site to your home screen, as an app. Again, there are a couple of reasons why you might want to do this that we will go over in the coming slides. Finally, of course, you're welcome to download the app from the Apple App Store or Google Marketplace, and either way, again, the user experience will be more or less the same thing. Why, then, would you want to use your browser and not install it from the App Store? One reason is that you may want to save a particular page as a bookmark, maybe one for your list page and another for your monthly zeros page, as an example. You can also control the font sizes, and if needed, there are easy ways to hide the URL toolbar to give you more room on the screen. We have short video tutorials on how to do this, all found in the user guide and our FAQ help pages. Using the website has those added benefits of adjusting the font size, but if you save the site to your home screen, it removes the URL toolbar automatically and treats it more like an app that you would download from the app stores. However, here, your font sizes can be saved, and you can even save two separate logins for the volunteers that operate two separate accounts. Again, we have some short videos on how to do this found in the user guide and our FAQ help pages. Finally, of course, again, you're welcome to install the same thing from the App Store or Google Marketplace. And the main loss here is that your inability to adjust the font sizes. This section details the settings section, available in the upper right corner of the screen, indicated by a green account menu icon. Going into the settings, the original defaults will be selected. Let's go into some detail. The units selector is importantly for viewing data only. If you live in Canada or have a metric-based account for entering data, this will default to metric. Otherwise, the default for viewing data will be in US units, but can be changed here or other places on the app where you are viewing data. The display selector is a new feature for CoCoRaHS app users, and any of these settings will be saved each time you return. When set to system, some smartphone users have their phones programmed to go into dark mode in the evenings, for instance, and this setting can accommodate that, or override it if you prefer one over the other at all times. The layout selector is primarily for determining where your menu will be when using the app. We'll explore the details next, but leaving it set to auto will force the app to be responsive to the width of your screen. Or if you prefer a specific menu style, you can override it on any device at any time. Let's check it out. The layout of your choice can be overridden in the settings at any time. But otherwise, if left to auto, the location of your menus will be determined by the width of your screen. Here, we are looking at all three layouts and the differences between them. And we'll go over each one in a little bit more detail. The mobile layout forces the navigation menu to the top of the screen with a drop-down menu. The tablet layout forces the navigation menu to the left side of the screen, and depending on the width, it may be collapsed when you navigate to a page, but it can be expanded or collapsed at any time. The home menu in tablet layout is located at the bottom of the screen. The desktop layout forces the navigation menu to the left side of the screen, just like the tablet layout, but here, the navigation menu will likely be open due to the width of your screen, and the home menu is now located at the top of the screen. Now let's review the options and details of the items found in the navigation menu. The My Stations page will display all stations associated with your account, open or closed, and will provide details about the period of record and links to view your data in the Data Explorer tool, or view it on the CoCoRaHS interactive map. Scrolling down, you will find details about the various data entry options and links to view or enter data, which are also found in the navigation menu. Let's go over all the forms. We won't go over every specific detail of every one of them, but we'll show some of the main features that can be found in most of them. The most common form is your daily precipitation form. So let's go over the highlighted details. There is a back button to navigate to the previous page, and you may receive a "Are you sure?" type of warning if you are in the middle of entering an observation and attempt to navigate away from the page. Next, in case you meant to submit a multi-day observation instead of a daily one, this is a quick link button to navigate to the multi-day accumulation form. If you have an account with multiple stations, you will have a drop-down menu to select the correct station. For the date and time section, there are toggles to advance or retreat a day at a time, or you can click on the calendar icon to select a day from the calendar. The calendar also has a Today button that will automatically fill in the current day if needed. The observation time also has an icon, and if you click on it, you can adjust your time of observation, and there is also a Now button here that will automatically fill in the current time. For your precipitation field, it defaults to 0, but you can click in the field to open your keypad, or you can click the Trace or NA/Missing button to quickly enter a trace or NA if needed. Clicking in the Observation Notes field will open up your keyboard where you can type or even press your microphone button to speak into your smartphone. For snowfall and snowpack, we now have a Set All Snow Fields to 0 button. But please, be careful here if you have any snow on the ground during the winter but did not do a measurement, please make sure to mark the snowpack fields as NA/missing and not 0. As a reminder, we have lots of training materials on how to measure and report snow, so please make sure to review them if you want to participate in snow measurements. Moving on, the multi-day form is available just as it was in the old apps. Here, we've included this hint where you can review your previous entries by looking at your monthly zeros form in case you need help remembering the first day after your last observation. The old apps always had a section saying hail and significant weather reports coming soon. Well, now that day has come. If you experience hail or any type of significant weather, you can submit a real-time report that will be immediately routed to your local National Weather Service office. These reports are supplemental, so please make sure to still submit your total amount on your daily 24-hour report the next morning. We've also added our condition monitoring report to the app, so please make sure to check it out and review the condition monitoring resource page for more information about submitting these reports. They really help the U.S. drought monitor, and these reports can become a fun part of your routine. Finally, upon popular request, we have added the monthly zeros form to the app. Here, you can review your history in a calendar format while also checking boxes to submit zeros for mornings where you want to report no rainfall. Also new, your monthly total is displayed in the space at the top of the calendar. Now we'll go over listing and editing your data. The links and icons for viewing your past reports are in the bottom section of your navigation menu. You can choose any of the report types, and once selected, the page will load your entire history of data entries. You can choose to view a report by clicking the list icon under Actions, and you can edit a report by clicking on the Edit icon. The date and time columns will be fixed, but you can scroll to the right to view more fields. You can also click on any column to sort the data by that field. So for instance, you can click on Gauge Catch, and it will sort the data from highest to lowest, and you can immediately view your largest amounts that you have ever submitted and see the list of dates for these reports. Finally, we recommend turning your phone sideways, where you can now view more fields. And new to the app, you can now see reports that contain comments too. Thanks for viewing this tutorial, and we would appreciate any feedback, which can be found in your account menu under Feedback. Thanks again, and we hope you enjoy using the app.